Almost 40 arrests have been made after climate protesters blocked both carriageways of the M25 this week during rush hour traffic.
Surrey police have issued the statement. Protesters have put their own lives at risk as well as those of others. But plans to impose an injunction could also affect peaceful protesters.
Joining us now, Liam Norton from Insulate Britain. We met him last week, says there's just no other option than to take this sort of action. And journalist Dawn Neeson, who thinks risking the lives of other people is never acceptable, no matter what the cause. So, welcome back, Liam.
Hi, Liam. Thank you.
Let's just have a look at those pictures of what happened around this time yesterday, because I'm all in favour of peaceful protest, but this is terrifying. You know, you're talking about the M25 and vulnerable human beings walking in front of cars, which could only stage just knock you over. I don't understand how this helps your cause.
And that's because, Susanna, and, you know, you're an intelligent journalist, right?
Yeah.
And you haven't understood what I said last week about what we do in the next 3 to 4 years will determine the future of
humanity. No, I understand it. I'm asking about those pictures. How is that helping your cause?
If you understood it, you might start to understand that a little bit more. And
Liam, just try not to be so patronising when you're talking to me, OK? I understand.
No, it's not about patronising.
No, it is.
It's the truth.
Sorry, your tone is patronising.
It's the truth.
I'm asking specifically about how you're helping your cause. Because I have to say, and you might not have heard the programme earlier, I'm extremely worried about what is now happening as a result of that protest, because I consider that there is potential overreach when it comes to seeking an injunction in this case. But I wonder whether what's happened is slightly backfired on you, because now the Home Secretary is going to get an injunction. You could have raised attention of this issue without putting all of these lives at risk. I mean, look at the traffic there. Mm. Are you not scared that one of your group might be killed doing this?
Yeah, absolutely.
And that's a price worth paying?
Well, the thing is, Susanna, this is the other truth, OK, is that your worry doesn't change climate change, doesn't affect what we do in terms of climate change. Worry doesn't do anything.
Mm.
And people have been worried for 30 years. People have been writing letters for 30 years. People have been sending in petitions for 30 years.
So it's worth risking the lives of your protesters. You would be prepared to lose your life over this. Is that what you're saying?
Well, what we're saying is we're in this awful position, aren't we? Where nobody is doing enough in terms of trying to save the next generation from destruction.
Okay, so would you be prepared to lose your life?
And we understand.
In order to raise awareness of this issue.
Well, and people are going to lose their lives, Susanna.
Okay, so the answer is yes.
Well, people are going to lose their lives if nothing's done.
And when we consider what that means, that is a motorist on the M25 hitting somebody.
It's terrible, isn't it?
But that's a price you think is worth paying to not only for a life to be lost, but for the impact that would have on a driver trying to go about their normal business. I mean, imagine the impact of that.
Well, the government have had weeks to give us a meaningful statement that they're going to act in terms of what it is that we're asking for. Mm. And Insulate in Britain will give the best value for money in terms of reducing emissions, hundreds of thousands of jobs, and it's going to stop tens of thousands of our elderly from dying each winter.
Well, actually, Susanna, what the government's doing, as we know, the Home Secretary is now going to court to seek an injunction in order to put people who are prepared to die for this cause
behind bars
to keep them off the motorways, so that that isn't on the conscience of any motorist who is involved. Dawn, as you listen to that, what do you think?
To be honest, I'm absolutely appalled, and I thought you were very patronising there, Liam. Why haven't you insulated your own home for a start? Because I think where you're coming from is pure hypocrisy as well.
Sorry, is that the case? Is your home not insulated, Liam?
Susanna, whether my...
Just answer the question, Liam. It's not, is it? We know it's not.
Whether my home is insulated or not doesn't change the fact that millions of people's homes aren't insulated.
Hang on a moment. Is this the case? You're saying you would risk your life for Insulate Britain, but you're not going to insulate your own home?
Susanna, the thing is...
Sorry if I sound patronising, but that sounds like you're completely sabotaging your cause.
The thing is, this is like a shame that this discussion has been debased in this way, because what we're talking about is the future of our country.
Yes.
Our country is going to be destroyed if we don't get in... if we don't get this sorted
out...
Doesn't
that start at home?
Well, you know, insulation costs thousands, tens of thousands of pounds. You're aware of that.
OK, so you're saying you can't afford to insulate your home?
No, what I'm saying is millions of people over
so
in
can,
the country...
So you can, it's just not.
Millions of people in the country cannot afford to do it. That's why millions of our people
so
are
So you're
in...
not insulating your home as a protest?
Do you think it's acceptable for millions of people in our country to be living in fuel poverty, tens of thousands of them to be dying in their homes, freezing to death? Do you think that's acceptable?
I can't understand why you wouldn't start with insulating your own home.
Whether that's true or not, do you think that's acceptable?
But
because
it is
that's
true,
what's
Liam.
Going on.
Right. Liam, can I just come in here now? This time last week when you came on, I put a couple of things to you. I read you the dictionary definition of fascism.
Yeah.
And it absolutely describes what your supporters are doing on the motorways. It is the act of a fascist regime to impose the will and the determination to impose some kind of global solution on the individual without consulting the individual and to dictate that to them. So I would say to you again that you are behaving like a fascist. I also predicted that we would be seeing serious consequences in the queues behind the blockages. And you told me that I was being hypothetical and you didn't accept it. Well, a couple of days later, a woman suffered a stroke sitting in a car in solid traffic with her son at her side. He was driving at a hospital because the stroke had started at home. She couldn't get to the hospital. She was in the car for 6 hours. She's now paralysed. That is a... You cannot argue that that is not a direct result of your protests. How can you possibly justify putting a woman in hospital who cannot speak and not move because she couldn't get to hospital in time because of what you were doing? What would you say to the son if he was standing in front of you right now?
Well, we've tried to get in touch with LBC to speak to Chris.
I don't care. What would you say to the son?
They've not had any correspondence with him
since. What would you say to the son?
We obviously feel terrible and I would apologise and say how bad I felt and he'd probably tell me to F off, you know, and I accept that. So, but what we're, it doesn't change the position that we're in terms of the climate and the position that we're left.
You don't lose any sleep about that. You don't lose any sleep about the fact that there is an elderly woman who is only in hospital, paralysed, because of what you've been doing. You don't lose any sleep about that.
Yeah.
Well, why are you still doing it then?
Because
it might happen right now.
Because
if your
guys
are on the M25 as we speak, there could be somebody else suffering a heart attack or a stroke or some other fatal incident, which wouldn't be happening if you weren't blocking the roads.
Richard.
It's going to happen again.
Richard, it's like we're on repeat because you're not listening to what I'm saying about the future of this country.
And you're not accepting responsibility for your actions. This is a classic
case. Can I just finish, Richard?
Well, because if you say something that's stupid, I'll cut you
Richard,
off.
Richard, go on. Yeah, I'm trying to... So, in terms of... You're not listening to what I'm saying in terms of the future of our country is at stake, so I've said that. But then the first thing
I
on the fascism...
I am listening and I agree with you.
But the fascism...
I actually agree with you that
fascism,
we should be insulating
the fascism,
I think you're right.
But, okay.
I think the government should be helping
okay,
to people
so on the
like
fascism,
you to pay for insulation.
Richard,
but
just,
what,
Richard,
the way that you're
Richard,
pushing the argument is... Fatal,
Richard.
Fatal consequences.
Okay, let me finish. Let me answer that question. So, in 1937, do you know how many ministers, how many MPs supported Churchill when he was trying to fight
Hitler? You've just got your fingers
Hitler.
In your ears, haven't you? You just cannot hear.
Do you know how many MPs supported Churchill
I don't care.
In 1937?
I'm not
six,
interested in Churchill.
Six MPs.
I'm interested in
six
people
MPs
who can't get
supported
to hospital
him.
Because of what you're
and
doing.
And Churchill was right, wasn't he? But he only had the support of six
You're
MPs.
You're comparing yourself to Winston Churchill.
No, I'm putting yourself into a historical situation that always, not always, the public are always with you, but you're still right. And we're right now. This is about what's right and what is wrong.
That is the most
and we're talking about the future
I've ever heard in a
of
debate.
Our country. We're talking about the destruction of our economy.
Okay.
And we're talking about the destruction of our health service. And you keep talking to me about hypothetical situations
it's
and you're refusing to listen
people
to the what I have to say about the future
that
of this country.
It was not a hypothetical stroke.
We're
okay?
right.
The accident,
we're
the,
right,
the,
OK?
The pile-up that
we,
took place behind
Richard,
your demonstrators 4 days ago...
Richard, we're right. We've been writing letters for 30 years.
..was not a hypothetical accident. It happened.
We've
These
been,
aren't hypothetical points.
We've been
They're
writing
facts.
Letters for 30 years. We've been writing petitions for 30 years. We've been pleading with our government for 30
and
years.
And now you're risking people's
and
lives.
What we're saying to the government is this... This is our line in the sand. We are demanding that the government make a meaningful statement to save the future of this country. And if they refuse to do it, then they can put us in prison. And that's the Home Secretary's decision. I've had enough of talking to people in this country about what we're doing.
You're doing a Piers.
This is the state of things.
Bye.
Yeah, bye.
So, gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen watching this programme, we now know that these protesters are actually following in the footsteps of Winston Churchill. That is the level of intellectual debate that they're able to bring to the table. They actually compare themselves to the stand that Winston Churchill took against Hitler. That's their parallel. What do we make of that kind of intellectual vapidity?
Well, I think that just demonstrates where this particular group of people are. And I take what you said about fascism, but I also would add that they are actually on a par with terrorism. And whenever I have this debate with anyone from that movement and they say, we are like the suffragettes were, well, the suffragettes did admit back in the day that they were terrorists. So they are literally admitting they are terrorism. And, you know, I've covered enough road traffic accidents and car crashes, and I've been to tell families that they've lost loved ones in car crashes. Mm. And you know what? Seeing them walk out on the M25 the other day brought back so many horrific memories. And if you were in a car with your family and you had an accident and caused a pile-up and you lost a child or you killed one of them, as you said, Susanna, you've got to live with that for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
This is not helping the cause.
Well,
we need to do something.
We might be getting this emergency injunction today, which means that if they go back, having been arrested and told that they can't go back, they break the injunction, they go to jail.
Richard? I would actually send them to China. Let them go and glue themselves to Tiananmen Square and see how far they get.
OK.
Dawn, thanks very much indeed. Liam, thanks very much indeed. Empty chaired himself. And I don't know, I would have thought you'd insulate your own home before you risked your life telling everybody else to insulate theirs.
But he doesn't take the point, does he? Or any of them?